Welcome to House of Destiny Family Church.
Be greeted in the name of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now it is time for declarations. Standing before you, my name is Wusane Bila. Let us pray before we start our declarations. Heavenly Father, I thank you. I give all the glory, I give all the honor. I thank you, Father, for allowing us, O God, to guide our Father in this fashion this morning. May your name be glorified, may your name be lifted up. You said in our word, where two or three gather in your name, you will be amongst them. We thank you for your presence right now, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our key declaration for this morning are based on the following key scriptures. Psalms 91 verse 5, 1 Peter 1 verse 23, 2 Timothy 1 verse 7, Romans 8 verse 28, and Luke 10 verse 19. We are praying for praise and thanksgiving. We thank God for the prophetic year of perfection, year 2020. We thank God for His sovereign love, His protection throughout the year of 2020. We thank God for being God above all gods and above all situations. I want us to declare for our country and will encourage you to say the following declarations after me. We decree and declare that South Africa is a God-fearing and a blessed nation. The blessing of the Lord is upon South Africa, and there is no harm that will befall this country. No disaster shall come near my country. We nullify the negative and devastating effects of the coronavirus in South Africa in mighty Jesus' name. South Africa is thriving socially, economically, and otherwise in the name of Jesus. Now we're declaring for our families. I decree and declare that all family members, those associated with me, are all protected in the name of Jesus. During this lockdown period, that favor, love, peace that surpasses man's understanding is on them in the name of Jesus. None of them will experience the loss due to coronavirus and the subsequent lockdown. Their businesses, their careers, and are progressing and advancing in the name of Jesus. The anointing of God in my life is destroying the spirit of confusion, the spirit of hopelessness, and the spirit of stagnation in their lives in Jesus' name. Now we're doing personal declaration. I decree and declare that 2020 remains my year of perfection in spite of what is happening in Jesus' name. Divine healing, good health, and sound mind is my portion in Jesus' name. I decree and declare that I have not been given the spirit of fear, but I'm given the spirit of sound mind. I decree and declare that we are seated in heavenly places, far above principalities and powers, far above the might and dominion. I am born of the incorruptible seed of the word of God, which gives life and abides in me forever. Therefore, I am an overcomer. I overcome every sickness and every disease, including the coronavirus, in Jesus' name. Every sickness, every virus and bacteria that enters my body, it instantly dies in the name of Jesus. My body functions as per the God's original design in Jesus' name. I overcome every challenge and difficulty, every infection and demonic operation. I overcome lack and failure in Jesus' name. I overcome fear and timidity in my life. I overcome the flesh, sin, and death. I overcome the deaths of the enemy. I overcome trials and temptations. The word of God declares that I will tremble over snakes and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and it shall not have harm on me. Hence, I decree and declare that the coronavirus is under my feet and it shall remain there in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare and I meditate, I confess that the word of God is my portion. I am the righteousness of God. I am God's elect, His workmanship of grace and love. I am God's eternal excellence. I am blessed and highly favored. I am what the word of God says I am. I can do what the word of God says I can do. I can do and declare that everything that I have said and decreed right now, it is declared and established in my life in the name of Jesus. May His name be glorified. Heavenly Father, we thank you yet for this opportunity in your presence. We give all the glory, we give all the honor. We thank that, Father, our country, South Africa, is a blessed nation. We thank that, Father, through the difficult time that we're experiencing as a country, we decree and declare your name that, Father, South Africa is safe in the name of Jesus. Be glorified and lifted up. Amen and amen.
It reaches to me. You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other. It reaches to me. You are my strength, Lord. Strength like no other. Strength like no other. Oh, and it reaches
to me.
Yes, you are my strength.
In the name of Jesus, amen. Standing before you, my name is Wisani Bill. I'm here to go through the unrecorded announcements and also to share a brief word of encouragement this morning. I would like to firstly acknowledge our pastor, Pastor Musa and Dr. Zamam Tlong, as well as the leaders of the church for allowing me to stand on this pulpit, amen. I want to extend my greetings to the entire church this morning. Welcome to church. I'll firstly go through the unrecorded announcements before I go through my word of encouragement. For our Sunday celebration services, all our Sunday celebration services will be live streamed from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Sundays via our Facebook page and YouTube page. Please follow us on at House of Destiny Family Church on YouTube and also House of Destiny Family Church on Facebook. Champions Chair and Friday Prayer. We'll be having 1 hour devotion on Wednesdays from 7 p.m. up until 8 p.m. The schedule will be sent to you via the email. We'll also be having a prayer every Friday via a webinar at 6:30 in the evening. The details will follow. For our Easter and Good Friday live streaming, we'll be having our live streaming for our Easter and Good Friday services. More details to follow soon. COVID-19 virus counseling line. The church has made available a spiritual support line. The number is as follows, 060-501-7046, mostly for counseling, prayer, and etc. Those believers who believe that they are infected or they know someone is infected by the coronavirus, they can contact the church via the number that I've just mentioned. Please note that you can request a callback on the number, and the number it is available for 24 hours a day and also 7 days a week. I want to take this time and acknowledge our pastor, Pastor Musa and Dr. Zamam Tlong, as well as the leadership of the church for allowing me to stand on this pulpit today. Amen. My name is Wisani Bill, and I'm here to share a brief word of encouragement. I want to extend my welcome to the entire church this morning. Amen. My key scripture is based on Job chapter 1, verse 8, and also Job chapter 19, verse 25. I'm reading from NIV version. Then the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There's no one on earth like him. He's blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil." Job 19, verse 25. "I know my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand upon the earth." Amen. I want to share briefly on the topic I've titled, "Speak What You Want to See." From the verse that we just read, the Bible describes Job as a man who was blameless, as a man who feared God, as a man who was in right standing with God. And the Bible says he was a righteous servant of God. But came a time in his life where he was going through a difficult time where he lost everything that he had. The Bible says he lost his properties and he also lost his children. As a believer, what do you do when you come across situations where you lose everything? What do you do when you come through situations or circumstances that seems to be too big for you? I want to draw some inspiration from the verse that we just read now. The Bible says this man had everything. He was in right standing with God, but he lost everything that he had. But one thing that I love about Job is that in the midst of what he was going through, he never lost his hope in God. He never lost his trust in God. And I want to encourage someone this morning. I don't know what is it that you're going through, but I want you to go draw some inspiration from what Job did. The Bible says this man, in the midst of what he was going through, he still declared that, "I know my Redeemer liveth." Amen. He said this word with authority and boldness, that "my Redeemer liveth." He said this word in the midst of what he was going through. And when he said these words, he didn't look at the current circumstances to dictate what is it that he has to say, but he still declared to God that, "I know that my Redeemer liveth." So I just want to encourage someone this morning. I don't know what is it that you're going through as a count, who are going through a difficult phase, a difficult time, but I want to encourage the board of believers this morning that irrespective of whatever and anything that we're going through, you can still declare and speak things that you want to see manifest in your life. You can still speak things that you want to see fully realized in your life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Some of the things that you have to speak, you speak them even though the situation currently doesn't seem like it, but you speak the things that you want to see manifest in your life. And I want to encourage you, you've got the power to speak what you want to see in your tomorrow. You've got the power to speak the things that you want to see in your future. Irrespective of whatever that you're going through, even in South Africa now, the COVID-19 is still instill fear in some of us, but I want to encourage the Church of God to stand and decree and declare the things that I want to see manifest in your life. Whatever mountain that seems too big in front of you, you have got a great goal that's on the inside of you that is greater than anything on this earth. And I want to encourage you, wherever you are, decree and speak things that you want to see manifest in your life. Do not allow situations to dictate what is it that you want to say, but speak the word of God. The word of God has got power, has got total authority over every situation, over each and every circumstance that you're going through. Be like Job. Take the posture of Job. Irrespective of whatever that you're going through, do not lose hope in God and His word. The Bible says the power of life and death lies on the tongue. You and I were empowered on the inside of us to speak the things that I want to see manifest in our life. And I want to say to you, be encouraged this morning. Never lose hope, irrespective of whatever that we're going through this lockdown. Stay in faith and declare the things that I want to see manifest in this country, the things that you want to see manifest in your life, in our career, whatever situation that you seems as if it's too big for you. The God that we serve is greater and bigger than any situation. Let's bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word this morning. We thank you for reminding us, oh God, that whatever that we want to see manifest, that whatever that we want to see fully realized in our life, we have to speak, we have to declare your word in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us, oh God, to stay our faith this morning. And we know that, Father, as a counter, oh God, we are not backing off. We are standing in the truthness of your word and decree and declare that South Africa is free and the entire world is free from this virus. We thank you that, Father, all of us, wherever we find ourselves in, we thank you that, Father, we are safe under your wings. We are safe under your shade. We thank you for your hand of protection over our lives in the name of Jesus. May your name be glorified and magnified this morning. Be lifted up, Heavenly Father. Now, cancer was.
Hallelujah. Be greeted. Once again, we want to give God all the praise and all the honor. Amen. We actually entering into an interesting time of offering. And I just want to share briefly about Genesis chapter 26. I'll read three verses. I'll read verse 1 and jump to verse 12 and verse 13. Verse 1 of Genesis chapter 26, it says, there was a famine in the land beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went to Abimelech, king of the Philistines, in Gerar. And verse 12 says, then Isaac sowed in that land and reaped in the same year 100-fold, and the Lord blessed him. The man began to prosper and continued prospering until he became very prosperous, for he had possessions of flock and possessions of herd and a great number of servants. So the Philistines envied him. Amen. Bazalane, as we get into an exciting time, a time of offering, of thanking God, it is quite interesting that the scripture that we've read here, it speaks of the fact that there was a famine. There was a coronavirus, or there was a tough time. There was a time of destruction in this land. And the scripture is very specific here that it says the famine that was here, it wasn't the first famine, and it wasn't, unfortunately, the last famine. But we'll get to that in another day. But what is important here is the fact that we know that this time, it was a time that was not necessarily conducive to giving. If ever there is a time that your flesh will tell you it is a time not to give, I can bet you that a famine in the land will probably not be the time to give. But little Bible here, in this time, Abraham or Isaac took advantage of this time. When we go through to verse 12, it says he sowed 100-fold. And it is quite interesting when you look at the results that we get when we give, when it does not make sense to give. This time that Isaac actually gave, it was not a time that the common sense will tell him to give. It did not make sense to him to give. Ideally, around this time, he should have held back to Imali or to whatever it is that he gave, because common sense would have told him that you do not know how long it's going to last. You do not know who takes your pelanin. So, hung on to it. But this Bible, Isaac did what is what was different or contrary to what his common sense was telling him. This Bible, he sowed in that land, in that time of famine. There is a blessing, Bazalwane, to give when there is a blessing, or when the environment tells us, or when the fleshly mind tells us we should not give at that particular time. This Bible, verse 12, he sowed in that land and he reaped in that same year. You will hardly find a scripture that says someone sowed and reaped at the same time. It is only when you begin to sow, when you are not ideally, or when you are not necessarily supposed to sow, when you reap in the time that you are not supposed to reap at, in the name of Jesus. Amen. And little Bible, not only did he reap in that same year that he sowed, even God went on to bless him. And I like verse 14. And this Bible, even Ama Philistines, even Abandu that were opposed to him, they began to envy him because he did what his common sense was telling you. I don't know what your common sense is telling you. I don't know what your mind, I don't know what your flesh is telling you, since we're not even having Ama services at church. But I want to encourage you that just like Isaac did, that in the time when it did not make sense to give, but he gave. If you want to experience a blessing of the same time, the blessing of the instant, it calls for you to give when the environment is not conducive for you to give. Little Bible, the Lord blessed him and he was very prosperous. Not that he was prosperous, but he was very prosperous. And it begins to count the things that he had. Little, for he had possessions of flock and possessions of herd and a great number of servants. Why did he have all of those things? It was because he gave. I want to encourage you, mtakama, wherever you are, mtakababa, ukuthi, this is not a time for you to. It is time for you to give, because God does this in this miraculous for all those who give that does not allow, or that common sense tells you not to give. So as we are about to give, I would like to encourage you. There is a blessing for you, a blessing, the instant blessing. Not only that, you will begin to count some of the flocks, some of the herd, the possessions of herd, and the great number of servants. I don't know what is it in your mind that represents the herd of flocks, but I want to tell you, in your life, in your family, in your career, in your business, when you begin to give, in the name of Jesus. As you give, please take out your seat as I'm about to pray. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise that as we are about to give, I thank you that the seed, environment conducive. I thank you that this seed shall germinate. It shall be a blessing, Heavenly Father, in their family, in the body of Christ, even during this difficult time, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, mighty God, that whatever it is in his or her life that represents Ama Philistines, I thank you that, Heavenly Father, they will begin to envy him or her on the basis of giving. In the name of Jesus, we give you the praise, the honor, and adoration in Jesus' name. Amen.
All things are working for my good.
Cause
is holy ground. So come and bow down. Oh, nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. Oh Lord, oh, oh, yeah. There's nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord.
Father, we thank you for this another precious opportunity to receive your living word. Your word, O God, is forever settled in heaven. Your word has final authority in our lives. All opinion every argument and every view. It ceases at your word. Heavenly Father, we know that there is nothing life that ever demands which has no solution in your word. Father, we thank you for confirming your word with signs and wonders in the lives of these your precious people. And we give you praise, glory, and honor in the name of Jesus. I am pleased that you have joined us on our online service. It is Church Without Walls. Thank you for opening your space so that we can bring hope into your homes. I trust that you will be blessed and encouraged by today's message, and sit, relax, and enjoy the word of God. In Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, the Bible declares that death and life are in the power of the tongue. Those who love it will eat its fruit. As we often say, the words we speak, the words we believe, they influence the outcomes of our lives. So it becomes important for all of us during this challenging time, during this tough time, that we continue to speak words that are positive, not speak fear, not speak defeat, but speak and decree victory over every life circumstance that we are finding ourselves in. And as it is our custom, I would like you to repeat these words with confidence, words with vigor after me. I have confidence in God and in His word. I am free from the bondage of fear, and I live by faith and not by fear. Today, I'd like to encourage you on a subject I have entitled, Reframe Your Fears. There are so many reasons why we can live in fear at this very point in time. The word reframe simply means readjust. It simply means have a different perspective, have a different point of view, look at an issue, look at the matter from a different angle. When we speak of fear, we are talking of doubt, talking of worries, anxieties about where we find ourselves, or worries about the future, or our families in terms of where we are, where they are, and where they could be. Our key scripture for this subject or this teaching is 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. The Bible says, God has not given us a spirit that makes us afraid, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-control. God has not given us a spirit that makes us afraid, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-control. Few things we learn from the scripture. One is the fact that fear is a spirit. Secondly, fear does not come from God. Fear is not a gift that God has given us. As a matter of fact, fear was introduced to us after the fall of mankind. The gift that God has given us, the scripture continues to say, it is a gift or a spirit of power, which simply means God has given us the ability or an enablement to get results in all the endeavors of our lives. Says God has given us not only the spirit of power, but the spirit of love, which is indeed God's true nature. And lastly, the scripture says God has given us a spirit where we are able to have a sound mind, an aptitude that helps us to make sound judgment or a thinking that is in line with the word of God. So I can safely, prophetically declare over your life that God has given you the spirit of power. God has given you the spirit of love. God has given you sound mind, meaning every battle that you and I face, we win that battle in the name of Jesus. That we are not taking any steps of regret because we know what to do. We know how to do what we need to do. And we know when to do what we need to do. And I can safely decree that the days of failure, days of fear, and days of frustration are over in the name of Jesus. No more fear, because fear is not what God has given us. Chains of fear that wants to hold us back, they are broken in the name of Jesus. So what is fear? Fear, it is being afraid of something, really believing that something is going to go wrong. It is that sense of uneasiness, that anxiety, that apprehension about something that is about to go wrong. In a spiritual sense, fear is having confidence that the things that the enemy says or the devil say to us, they will come, they'll become a reality in our lives. Of course, there is the fear of God, which is a strong degree of reverence. It is an honor, an adoration, or esteeming God higher in our lives. That gesture that is indicative of deep worship to God. So we're not speaking about that fear of God, but it's fear that says something will go wrong. That sense of uneasiness that something is about to go wrong in my family, about to go wrong in my life, that anxiety, that apprehension. It is the fear that we need to reframe our lives from. Why do we need to reframe our lives or reframe our fears? Number one, the scripture tells us in Genesis chapter 3, verse 9 and 10, that fear leads us or drives us away from God, who is our source. You know, there are a lot of things that are happening at the current or the present moment that wants to drive us away from our source. And I'd like us to have a spiritual perspective of where we find ourselves as families, where we find ourselves as a country, that we give this time a spiritual perspective. But when we are gripped by fear, fear will drive us away from God. Genesis chapter 3, verse 9 and 10, the Bible says, God is asking a question. He says, Adam, Adam, where are you? He says, I have heard your voice. I was afraid because I was naked and I hide myself. So fear leads us to move away from God. God is our source. The Bible is very clear that when God created mankind, he spoke to himself. Meaning, for us to have life everlasting, for us to have life that is fruitful, a life that is thriving, a life that gets result, we always have to be connected to our source, and our source is God. But when we live under fear, fear will drive us away from God. Secondly, why we need to reframe our fears is that fear connects us to the things that we hate the most. Fear, remember, is a spirit, and fear, therefore, is a spiritual connector. So fear connects us to the things we dread the most. Fear connects us to the things we hate the most. Job chapter 3, verse 25, when everything has happened, Job says this word, everything I have feared, everything that I dread the most has happened to me. So fear connects us to the things that we hate or things that we fear the most. If we fear that we're going to lose our jobs, it is only a matter of time that we lose our jobs. If it is fear that drives us, that says we're going to be sick, we're going to die, sooner rather than later, fear will connect us to the things that we fear the most. Hence, we say we need to reframe our lives, making sure that we live in faith and not live in fear, because fear connects us to the things we dread or hate the most. Fear leads us into being worried. Matthew 6:27, the Bible clearly speaks. It says, no one can add even an hour of his life when they live in fear. So when we are faced with things that are challenging in our lives, we have to hand them over to God. When our lives, our marriages, our families, our businesses, our careers, our children are going through tough time, we have an opportunity to give those issues and those things to God and not live in worry, not live in fear, because God says we will not add an ounce of our lives when we live in worry. Why we need to reframe our lives or reframe from fear, it is because fear will connect us to the things we are afraid of. Lastly, fear makes us to question. The reason why we need to reframe our fears, fear makes us to question whether we can trust God. It makes us to question whether we can trust the truth of the word of God. You know, fear will cause us to say, you know, whatever God has said, it will not be true in our lives.
Fear will say, God is saying, I will not leave you nor forsake you. And the enemy and fear will say, look, you are on your own. No one cares about you. Fear will say, God's word will say, I will go before you and level mountains. But fear will tell you that, you know what, you are moving from crisis to crisis. You are doomed. You are about to fail. You are about to give out or give in. But when we live our lives believing the truth of the word of God, when fear speaks, we choose to believe the word of God. God says, do not be afraid. Let go to the other side. I will be with you. And fear will say, you know what, it is over. But I want to encourage you that we don't have to live in fear, because fear will connect us to the things we fear the most, things we hate the most. Fear will cause us to question the confidence we have in the word of God. And as a result, we need to be steadfast, knowing that we are unshakable, we are unmovable, because we believe in the truth of the word of God. So how do we do what I've just said? How do we reframe our fears? Reject fear. Refuse fear to assault your confidence in God and in his word. Why do you need to do that? Because God is not a liar. God will come through for you. God will come through for your family. God will come through for our country. He says in Numbers 23 verse 19, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent or change his mind. He said, has he ever said and not do what he has said? Has he ever spoken and not made good on what he has said? So we can have confidence that God will perform and fulfill his word. So reject fear. Refuse fear to assault your confidence in God. Remember, secondly, that you are backed by God's unwavering promises and God's power. Isaiah 41 verse 10, the Bible says, fear not, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. He says, I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. You can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. So we have to know that even when we go through this challenging and difficult time, we are not on our own. We are backed by God's promises, unwavering power, unwavering promises. And God is orchestrating a way out for us. He says, fear not, for he is with us. Lastly, why and how can we reframe fear? It is, we can remain in the truth. Through remaining in the truth of God's word, we have to not throw away our confidence in God, because our confidence in God has the greatest reward, according to Hebrews chapter 10, verse 35. When we believe right, we begin to live right. When we believe right, we begin to behave right. When we believe right, knowing that the God that we serve will surely come through for us. He will not leave us on the ledge. He will not leave us stranded. He will not mismanage our lives. That's why we can have confidence to look at him, our circumstances notwithstanding. When we believe that we are victims, sooner rather than later, we will be victims. When we believe that we are failures, we are not good for anything, sooner rather than later, that is what will be the reality of our lives. But this day, I want to encourage you to look at God, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Reject fear. Remember that you are backed by God's unlimited power. God, backed by God's promises that will surely come to pass. Stay true to the word of God, because the word of God will surely come alive in your life. Reframe from your fears. Let's not embrace fear. Let's not embrace lack. Let us not embrace sickness. Let us not embrace lack. But let us embrace the fact that God is taking us through, even through these challenging and difficult times. It is in the name of Jesus that we overcome, that we go through, that we press forth. And I trust that you have been encouraged in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We thank Heavenly God that we'll reject fear, that will not embrace being scared, will not embrace being assaulted in our confidence in you and in your word. We give you praise, we give you glory, that we are breaking forth and we are breaking through. Father God, we thank you that our nation is blessed. We thank you that our families is blessed. Families are blessed. We thank you, Heavenly God, that we are crossing over and we are going over even coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, be exalted, lifted up high, and magnified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
And we will never settle for less, 'cause we know there's more that's found in you. We will never settle for less, no, 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 no.
Oh,
more that's found in you. It's in you, Lord. Yes, it's in you, Lord. And we know there's more that's found in you.
House of Destiny Family Church, taking you to the next level.